no one like you, Lord. I'm not just gonna leave the song, you sing too. There is no one like you, Lord. In heaven or earth, there is no one like you, Lord. No one like you.
There is no one. There is no one.
enough, yeah. Your presence, Lord. I can't get enough of your presence, Lord. Cause there is no one like you. I can't get enough of your presence, Lord. But I'm gonna try.
No. does.
Yeah.
Goes around. He will gather people. Anyway, he was in the auto shop Friday, and people were just coming around in the auto shop. That's what he does. He'll just he'll pull up a chair anywhere.
So it's like
people come and worship.
So he's in place of the platform of the Lord's given.
Yes. It's funny, the people that we go in their store and
do you ask them or do you just start playing? You ask them and if they're open, then
I'll sit in the back of my van and play.
Yeah.
And sometimes I'll come out and go, are you coming outside or not?
Yeah.
I give us some. Yeah. You sound good. Okay.
That's the word of the Lord.
Praise God.
Yes.
Well, there's people go, oh, there's black music being played over here, and who's this guy? Oh, go in here and listen to the worship while I pray. Oh, that's what's going on here?
Pretty much we knew.
And so that's witnessing for us, is I'll just be playing spontaneous.
And,
you know, the atmosphere is changing. People are, you know, angels are surrounding and they're bringing people. And then he'll pray for them.
Praise God.
There was one fella that I was praying for. He goes, you have 2 minutes. I said, well, I said, I will ask the Lord to leave.
That's funny.
And I said, can I put my hand on his shoulder? So I lay my hand up and I start praying.
Wesley, yeah. Okay.
And then he's in my ear and I said, I thought you said 2 minutes. And I said, 2 minutes. And I kept playing. So after about 5 or 6 minutes, thank you. And he's a little perturbed, but he's all right. And he walks about 8 blocks.
He
gets drawn back and he goes, I can't leave this area. What is going on? Why can I not leave here? I said, it's called the Holy Spirit. Just be still. He would not move. He was just like this. He goes, I want to know more about this. And I told him everything, and he was just like, I'm going to go home and read my Bible. It's just things like that happen. We have people coming out of the bars crying, saying, I don't want to be an alcoholic anymore. We have people that walk out of the bar lines and go home and say, after you're done praying for me, I don't ever want this life anymore. We have people that have come out and they're singing gospel music from the bar.
Just
please pray for me.
And then I, Maryland,
coffee, whatever, and then we'll have some personal prayer time.
There's a swingers bar, swingers club across from where I take care of a resort. And she was meeting with the manager. She wanted to get saved. We've been praying for the place for years. Wow. This is a dream.
Oh, in a dream.
Yeah. Well, I had a dream. I had a dream a couple years ago of Michelle Obama preaching.
Wow.
I mean, I was listening to her preach.
Wow.
So she's gonna get saved.
Praise God.
Can you imagine what a powerhouse? I mean, the same as
Kanye West.
Yeah. So just imagine, you know, God is. I mean. God is touching some of these people, especially with this basketball player dying, Kobe.
Yeah.
I mean, hearts are being touched right now. I'll guarantee you that she's getting, some people are getting softened up. Something's taking place.
More youth are on fire for Christ.
Yes.
I have one kid. Look out his window, saw us doing saturate, ran out of the house and said, I went to a different church. Are you guys doing saturate? I want to help you guys.
You familiar with saturate? Where you take and put a DVD on people's door. It's like a little bag, and you put a DVD on their doorstep, on their door handle. It's been happening all over the country.
What do you get? What DVD do you?
The Jesus movie.
The Jesus movie.
Yeah, in many different.
Well, Reinhard Bonnke did that with the Book of Life or whatever he was handing out.
Okay.
Throughout the whole country. He sent one to every address.
Nice.
About $1 million.
Yeah, I can imagine.
I had to.
Hey, so worth it.
One night I was walking to the store, and there was this young man that was walking by, and was with another guy that evangelizes. He has his own little ministry going on. And we were asking everybody left and right. The Spirit was just moving, so we're just like hitting it, just like whatever. When the Spirit's moving, let's just move with it. Let's not be quiet. So we're like, can we pray for you? Yes. Can we pray for you? Yes. Ooh, young man, 17, he comes up. He's walking home. I said, hey, young man, Jesus loves you, and I love you. Can I pray for you? And he goes, wow. Like that, I said, what? He goes, you know what? I needed to hear that today.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
I'm having trouble at home. I'm having trouble at school. And I'm so on fire for God, but my family doesn't understand. I need to be in a church. Can you point me into a church? Can you do this and this and this and tell me this and tell me that? And I was like, hallelujah, Lord, that you're showing me that these youth are rising up behind us and then moving forward.
Yeah, people think that they're not interested in God. They're more interested in God.
I said, you know what, young man? I said, even if you're one, you're going to be mighty because you have the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit with you, and you're going to, God's going to use you mightily in that school.
But they don't want religion. Right. They want a real experience because they've experienced some of the evil spiritual stuff. So if they know that's real, so they know that God must be real.
This is what this young man was talking about.
Yep.
And then I said, well, you're going to be used mightily in your school. I said, don't stop professing his name in school around your friends or whoever, you know. So it's just on fire with these youth that are coming out, and a lot of